there. Welcome to Football on Five. Not quite a full house of EFL action for you this week due to cup commitments, but Caroline Barker will be eyes down as usual with all the big stories. And unlucky for some, Clinton Morrison will be telling it like it is. And we begin at Craven Cottage, where it was all about the numbers. Fulham, with 23 points from the last 27, have surged into the top six. The visitors were Aston Villa. Seven wins in a row had taken them to second. Legs 11 on each side.
Every reason to expect a match to savour down by the Thames, and Fulham vigorously set about disrupting Aston Villa's push to return to the Premier League. Matt Target with the first reminder the home side have momentum, which could soon force them into the automatic promotion frame. Helped, they hope, by the January acquisition of Alexander Mitrovic, who promises to provide a focal point for the Whites' attractive approach play. The serve close to marking his full debut with the opener. The absence of Jack Grealish and the potent Albert Adoma wasn't helping Villa's cause. Back in the starting lineup, Birkir Bjarnason did his best to fill the void, but the scoreline remained an accurate reflection of a tight half. Fulham were soon on the front foot again, though for all their bright movement around the box, the home side weren't giving Villa keeper Sam Johnston much in the way of serious work. Not enough power on Foyd Oyute's shot to make this anything more than a routine catch. Steve Bruce's men hadn't conceded a goal on their travels in the last three league games, edging them all 1-0. They knew that run was over just 7 minutes into the second half, when Ryan Frederick showed Alan Hutton a clean pair of heels, with Fulham's ruthless youngster waiting in the centre, the eighth goal in nine championship games for Ryan Sessegnon. Behind in a league fixture for the first time since Boxing Day, this was a test of Villa's confidence, and Johnston appeared to have too much, Ayite seizing on the over-ambitious free kick. The Craven Cottage crowd roared its approval with their team in the mood for more. Fulham had the chance to become just the second side in the league all season to put three past that John Terry-led defence. Frederick's leading the charge and Mitrovic continuing to make a good impression before Sessegnon showed another aspect of his burgeoning talent with a precise cross, only to find Ayite's more accurate from inside the centre circle than just 6 yards. Even so, it would take something special to save Villa now. Bjarnason tried to spark a fight back by picking out Scott Hogan. When even he can't hit the target, it's not going to be your day. It was definitely Fulham's who should now take huge self-belief into a key run of fixtures. They could have scored more, Kevin McDonald next to trouble Johnston. But a two-goal success sets them up nicely for three more games over the coming fortnight against teams in the top six. Villa may just be glad this one is over with, looking a little ragged by the time Abubakar Kamara skipped him from the wing. Their aim is to regroup quickly and start afresh when Preston pitch up in the Midlands on Tuesday.
You never like to get beat, but there's a long way still to go. We've a lot to play for. We've had an incredible run. We'd love to have kept it going. We weren't quite good enough on the day. We were dealt a major blow without two players who've been really instrumental in that, with the loss of Grealish and Adoma. They've been key to us over the last 6 weeks, 7 weeks. So let's see how they are on Tuesday and next Saturday and see if we can get that momentum back and that winning habit again.
We are like more mature men. We started the season like young men. I made many mistakes. We now made less mistakes. We play better football. We are more solid. We are. We take another cliché. We are like mid-age men, actually, right now, and we are working in the direction for a really big adult team.
I think second place is definitely up for grabs now. The fact that we absolutely bossed the game against a Villa side that I think most teams are scared of, it means that we're definitely going to be in the hunt. What today did, it sealed our place in the playoffs, I think. And after the experience of last year losing that to Reading, I think we'll be much stronger and certainly a force in the playoffs.
The team I fear most is probably Fulham in the running, to be honest. I think Cardiff, I think they'll drop off. I've always said they'll drop off. But yeah, Fulham gives them all the momentum. They've unbeaten in, 10 now. And hopefully we can just pick it up next week and give ourselves an opportunity to land that second spot in automatic promotion.
Clinton, let's go back to what Jukanovic said. Was he said, look, we've grown into men this season, yet the player that keeps making our mouths water, we need to get him a fake ID to take him for a pint. Ryan Sessegnon, I'm sorry to repeat it, but every week?
Yeah, and it seems every time I'm on the show, I'm always talking about him. He's been brilliant. I think he's been sensational. For only 17 years of age, he's so mature, he's such a good footballer, and he's getting rave reviews. So he He's been fantastic for Fulham so far.
Yeah, I hadn't seen him today. He was absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, he was brilliant. He was a revelation. His goal was a very good finish. You can see here, it's a great run from Fredericks and Sesa Young. He pulls out. Young players would make a run across the near. He pulls out, and it's a very good finish from Sesa Young into the bottom corner.
His football brain's way beyond 17. Is it way too early to start talking about the England senior team having a look at him, because he stands out every week?
Yeah, I just think you got to just let the kid develop, let him enjoy his football at Fulham. He's working under a very good manager, and then his time will come, and he'll slowly get him up through the age groups and then to the under-21s. But he will be an England international, that's for sure.
And another Englishman was sorely missed today, wasn't he, and Jack Grealish?
Yeah, Jack Grealish, I think he's a star. He gives Villa, he's that X factor. He creates everything, gets on the ball. And they also missed Albert Adoma as well. He's their top goal scorer. He's been brilliant for them this season as well.
Talking of goals, Aite, this is clever, isn't it? You still got to score from this far out.
Yeah, it's a bad kick from Sam Johnston, and it's a great finish from Aite. He could have rolled it inside foot, but he might not have got enough pace on it. But the technique to finish that and drill it like that into the bottom corner is a great finish.
What was that, 42 yards?
Yeah, 42 yards. I would never have scored from that, yeah. No goal.
So of all your goals you scored as a professional footballer, where was the furthest out you scored from? Is there a Clinton Morrison Beckham moment from inside his own half? Okay, 30 yards then.
No,
right?
I couldn't reach. 18 yards was the furthest.
18 yards?
Yeah, but I did go into the top corner, mate.
Okay, on the way, more action from the top of the championship. And we're at Preston, who are desperate.